I'm watching last night the College Football Playoff Committee just to see where Minnesota was going to be ranked because they're my Gophers here. I'm one of the few in the media not surprised that they beat Penn State. P.J. Fleck, the head coach of the Gophers, our Gophers, joining us, Continental Tire Coach's Corner. How's the voice today, Coach?
Boys are elite, getting ready to go out to the practice field.
Appreciate
you having us on the show.
All right, when you saw the big reveal last night, eighth in the ranking, what was your reaction?
Well, the reaction was really positive, just in general, that we're very fortunate, we're very humbled to represent the University of Minnesota, the great state of Minnesota, and all of our fans and alum. I think that's really important when you're getting national attention and on a show like that for a half hour, and a lot of the show has to do with the University of Minnesota, so very positive in how we are able to represent the university and our state.
Did you think you were going to get ranked higher?
I don't think there was any expectation, to be honest with you. I think this team has really stayed away from that all year. We've talked about it. We've walked them through it. They've been preparing this since January. And to be honest, I don't think anything shocks this football team. You know, successful people and successful teams are usually not shocked by the success they have or what other people think of them because they've been preparing for it. And the pressure comes along with that. They've been preparing for that pressure for a long time. So I don't think anything shocks this football team. They just got to continue to get better. This is a one-game championship season against Iowa. They've been incredibly focused on one week at a time type mentality all year, and that's why they're in this position, the only reason why they're in this position. So there's nothing that we have to change at this point except just be better today than we were yesterday.
But you know that the inevitable question comes about that the letdown. You have this emotional win, one of the great wins in the program's history, and now you go to Iowa. How do you tell your kids, even though they know it and you know it, not to have a letdown against Iowa?
Well, this team is not built for any letdowns. You know, the game of football, that's why you play. You just never know what's going to happen. There's a lot of people who probably didn't think we were going to be able to beat Penn State. I think since week four, people have been saying that to us. Well, yeah, but they haven't played so-and-so. Mm-hmm. Yeah, but they haven't played so-and-so. And, oh, they just beat this team. Can they come back and beat this team now? And we've not ignored all of that. We've listened to all of that because, as with young people, they only have them for 2 hours a day. You know, technically, when you look at the actual timesheets, right, you have them for about 2 hours where you can really influence them. Every other hour of the day is spent outside through social media, the media, other people that talk to them. So the message that you give them has got to be very clear and very direct. And it's got to be able to take all that outside noise, bring it inside, process it, and let your culture be able to spit it back out, and hopefully the right way. But this team has taken a one-game approach, and that's all they're going to continue to do. I mean, yesterday's Tuesday practice was the best Tuesday practice we've had. And that's all I can continue to ask of our players is they just keep changing their best.
For more Dan Patrick Show, tune into Audience Channel 239 on DirecTV, stream for free on BR Live, or download the Dan Patrick Show app.